All right, you know this famous slogan, beef, it's what's for dinner. I don't say it as well, but here are some recipe ideas from local Denver chef Jennifer Jasinski. Chef, it's an honor to have you on our show today. Many of us here in Denver know about your wonderful restaurants, but this is something different. I can't wait to hear how this latest technology is actually being brought to kitchens nationwide.
It is so cool, and thank you, Gina. I'm so happy to be here, too. Tons of technology in the kitchens nowadays, from immersion circulators, air fryers, pressure cookers, but the coolest thing, I think, is we now have Chuck Knows Beef, which is a beef virtual assistant. So this is so cool. You can have it on your phone or your smart speaker, and you can ask it for recipes or how much protein's in beef, so many things.
You've got to explain this a little bit more because this sounds fascinating. How exactly then does it bring that virtual farm into the kitchen with technology?
Well, so Chuck Knows Beef is funded by farmers and ranchers, and all that knowledge that they bring to the table goes into Chuck Knows Beef. So you could ask how cows are raised, how much protein is in beef, all kinds of really cool things. You just say, hey, Google, open Chuck Knows Beef, and it starts spitting out information to you, which is really cool.
I think we all could use something like that in our kitchens, no matter what the recipe is, but especially when it comes to some of that, because I know I myself get a little intimidated when I try to cook steaks and things like that, so this is perfect. I'd love for you to share some of your recipes, though, some of your favorites.
Yeah, so we have a beautiful beef pot roast, and I have chosen to make this recipe. It's from Chuck Knows Beef is on there, and I like to make this in the pressure cooker because it takes a recipe that normally is 6 hours to 60 minutes. So beef pot roast with a cider gravy. I caramelize all the onions, garlic, ginger, thyme right in my pot, put my chuck roast in there, put my cider in there, and it comes out so tender and delicious.
Ooh, boy, that does look delicious. Okay, so for those of us who are still new to this and trying to figure it out, and we can't have you come to our kitchen every day, explain a little bit about how we can really get the most out of Chuck Knows Beef.
Yeah, I mean, so I say, hey, Google, open Chuck Knows Beef. Ask for recipes. You can get a shopping list for recipe, like sent to your phone. Just go to beefitswhatsfordinner.com or chuckknowsbeef.com and get started there and just play around and have some fun.
Well, that sounds perfect. Anyone who can have a little help in the kitchen, for those of us who are not professionals like yourself, if we can have something as simple as Chuck Knows Beef and just say, hey, pull it up for me or help me with this recipe that I'm trying to do at home to impress my family, this sounds phenomenal. Chef, once again, having a local celebrity like yourself here on our show today has been a pleasure and an honor. Thank you so very much.
Thank you, Gina. Have a great day.
BeefItsWhatsForDinner.com offers a recipe box full of ideas so you can beef up any meal. This segment is paid for by Cattlemans Beef Board and National Cattlemans Beef Association.